Perhaps one of the most sinister things that the Dark Lord of the Sith, Vader, has ever done is not allowing his failed apprentice, Galen Merrick, to rest. After Galen Merrick's death upon the first Death Star, Darth Vader cloned his apprentice, still hoping that the power of Galen Merrick would be enough for him to one day overthrow his own master, Darth Sidious. Therefore, for years, Darth Vader cloned Galen Merrick again and again, until he was eventually somewhat successful with the clone in Starkiller. Starkiller being the character and clone that we follow over the events of The Force Unleashed 2, a character that's still tortured by the memories of Galen Merrick, despite, of course, as we learned at the end of that game, him being a clone himself. But Galen Merrick's body was not the only thing that Darth Vader experimented on Kamino. There were other things that Darth Vader wanted to perfect. Unknown to Vader at the time, though, his two experiments would one day interlock with one another, and Galen Merrick would get to wield the experimental lightsaber crystals that Darth Vader had been working on for years. As I mentioned, the clones of Galen Merrick were not the only thing that Darth Vader was experimenting with on Kamino. Darth Vader was also experimenting with a new type of lightsaber crystal known as an impact crystal. An impact crystal was a normal lightsaber crystal by all accounts to begin with. However, Darth Vader had ordered stormtroopers to make machines that literally poured energy into these lightsaber crystals. The goal of Darth Vader was to create a lightsaber crystal more powerful than any other, and that would allow him to cut through other lightsabers with ease, as well as grant Darth Vader the power to switch the blade intensity from on and off. In the end, though, there were only two lightsaber crystals that Darth Vader was successful with, both of them being yellow in coloration. Darth Vader ultimately decided to name these two lightsaber crystals impact crystals. These impact crystals were a variation of compressed energy crystals. A compressed energy crystal being a lightsaber type that was very popular among Sith Lords, that created a sort of pulsating lightsaber crystal as it pulsated with power. The power that were within the impact crystal, though, was not light or dark side in origin, it was simply energy. Therefore, why the color produced was yellow and not green, blue, or dark side in nature being red. It had no true allegiance within the Force. The impact crystals were simply pure energy, and as a result of it, also created a blade that pulsed with energy. It is described that the impact lightsaber crystals were far more precise than any lightsaber that Darth Vader had used previously. However, unfortunately, Darth Vader would never get to wield these twin lightsabers in combat, as instead, the rogue clone Starkiller would eventually break free and come across these two impact lightsaber crystals, ultimately choosing to take them for his own and place them within his lightsabers. This was one of many reasons why Darth Vader would grow to fear the clone of Starkiller, as he himself was unstable in energy and nature within the Force, and along with this untamed energy had two lightsaber crystals that Darth Vader considered to be some of the most powerful crystals in all of Star Wars. The clone of Galen Merrick Starkiller would do a lot of damage with these two lightsaber blades. However, their ultimate fate would be unknown, as Darth Vader did not see them in use when he attacked Starkiller again on Kamino, meaning unfortunately for Vader, he would never get to reacquire his impact lightsaber crystals, although he would still seek them out. But that is everything we know about the yellow impact lightsaber crystals used predominantly by the Starkiller clone, and how Darth Vader had developed these lightsaber crystals in use for his own lightsaber. But of course, they were ultimately stolen from him, and Darth Vader would never see them again. But what are your guys' thoughts on the yellow impact lightsaber crystal, and had you ever heard of this lightsaber crystal before this video? I also want to hear your thoughts on the Starkiller Galen Merrick story overall, and what are your opinions on it? And do you think not allowing Galen Merrick to rest is one of the darkest things in all of Star Wars, as Darth Vader simply would not let his former apprentice die? Anyway, my friends, thank you guys so much for watching this video. May the Force be with you, and have a great day.